Listen to this one. A Florida jury has returned one of the largest verdicts ever against a tobacco company. Cynthia Robertson sued R.J. Reynolds because her husband had died of lung cancer after a lifetime of smoking. She will be awarded more than $16 million in compensatory damages and, wait for it, $23 billion in punitive damages. Her attorney, Willie Gary, is here with us in the studio. So, welcome to the program.
Good to be here.
I didn't know you were the attorney for the plaintiff. I did not know that. Thank you very much for being here.
Good to be here.
Now, I think she's not going to get $23 billion.
Well,
you know that's not going to happen.
You never know. You never know what the court is going to do.
But
more than anything,
you'd be one
else,
of the richest men in the world if you got that.
Well, the point is, it's not about being rich. It's not about the money. It's about making a difference. It's about saving lives. You got 480,000 people die every year.
Yeah, hold on a second.
Every single year.
I got it. Hold on a second.
Good. Now, know your question. Bring it up.
Look, we've had this debate. And the tobacco companies have paid out, what, $145 billion? And now we're going back into it and they've got to pay some more? Look, should we be trying to put tobacco companies out of business by lawsuits?
Well, we should send them a message that they can make a safer cigarette, they may make a few less dollars, and they should do it. They owe it to the American public to do it. You recall cars, you recall vehicles to make them safer. And you also have to. You have to give people a right to make an informed decision. And that's what what it's about.
Everybody knows that
okay,
how
let me ask you this.
Not know?
What about a 10-year-old?
Well,
tell me about a 10-year-old. Do they know?
Okay, so cannot tell a 10-year-old, and a 10-year-old doesn't realize that tobacco smoking is bad for you, therefore ban cigarettes?
No, make them safer. What's wrong with making them? Yes, you can. We got documents to prove that they can make them safer. That's all we're asking.
But recall
the bad ones that's killing people to the tune of 480,000 people a year.
Okay, how many people die of sclerosis?
How many people
die of sclerosis of the liver?
That's not the point. Does that give you a right? Does that give you a right still to kill people?
What? How many people die of sclerosis of the liver because they drink alcohol?
That's not the
point.
That's not
the point. So why don't you take on the liquor companies?
It's real simple and it's real clear. You cannot withhold information. Look, the Supreme Court has ratified. You cannot withhold information about your product that's detrimental, and people rely on it to their detriment.
That was taken care of with $145 billion.
It was not.
Stayed outside of it.
They're still doing the same old thing. They are killing people. You know, in this century, we're going to hit 1 billion people.
I'm just curious as to at what point does the person smoking bear any responsibility? Because, okay, you're talking about a 10-year-old, but at some point between 10 and whatever age people are dying, they know that this is not a product that's good for them.
And it's too late.
So everyone smoking took up the habit at 10 years old?
That's the point. You don't have the right. Go after me, but you don't have the right to go after our children. You don't have the right to go
after children.
How do you know that? I've been in a trial for 2 months. I've seen over 100,000 private non-disclosed documents that they had to...
Does the smoker bear any responsibility?
Yes, the smoker bears some responsibility.
We can eat ourselves into a diabetic coma. At what point do you blame the people?
Do you not blame the manufacturer at all?
Someone could smoke one cigarette a day. Would they die from that?
Do you not blame the manufacturer at all?
No, I don't. I would not. Not at this point.
When they used to market
cigarettes as something that would help you athletically and those things, absolutely.
Do you agree that they should market children, high school students?
Of course not.
Well, then, that's it. That's what they do.
Okay. We appear to have come to an impasse, but I, for one,
do not want to be with you.
It's going to be with you, too. You're a rich man.
No.
You get 30%
of $23
million.
It's not about the money. It's about making a difference. Okay. It's not about... I'm a lawyer. I'm a trial lawyer, and I fight for my clients.
Would you reject
but it's
$7
not about
billion?
The money?
If you get $7 billion out of this, you'd reject
it? The jury spoke loud and clear. They said to tobacco, you're not going to get away with this. You've been killing people for a number of years. You've been lying to people.
We should have a law that says tobacco is illegal.
Now, you don't need a law. You don't need a law to do the right thing, morally, to do the right thing.
Then you shouldn't put them out of business with a lawsuit.
You think there should be a law that's saying to tobacco, tobacco don't target our children?
No, I think there should be a law. If we want to pass the law that says
that
tobacco is banned, I'm fine with it. If you want to pass that law, do it.
That's
not
a law.
Put them out of business by lawsuit. It just enriches you.
Look, well, my point is, don't put them out of business, but make them make a safer cigarette.
I'm up against a hard break, and I got no choice. But, counselor, you were fun. If you're not careful, you're going to come back, okay? Good luck, sir.
Good luck.
All right, cable.